Agni, one of the most accurate nuclear missiles in the world. Meet the woman who made it. She may be homemaker to a family, but is known as Agniputri to the world.
From very beginning, I was been doing for the Agni program. And within this 20 years, I've taken up as a project director.
It all started way back in Alappi, Kerala. After a BTech from Thrissur Engineering College, her fascination for radar and missile systems took over, and she joined the Defense Research and Development Organization, or DRDO.
Hardly within a week, I got this call letter to join within 2 days' time. So I had to immediately rush, whereas I thought I will at least relax for a month at home, which I couldn't, I'm still yet to waiting for that.
And within a few years, Dr. Thomas helped develop an advanced missile guidance system.
This is first of its kind in within our country developed. In flight, whatever target you want, we are confident of the navigation and the guidance schemes. So it will take you to the target.
But it doesn't stop there. She helped develop another groundbreaking technology known as RVS, or Re-entry Vehicle System. This lets the missile re-enter the atmosphere at a thundering velocity and a temperature of 3000 degrees Celsius.
It's a technology which nobody is going to give you. So you have to in-house develop the technology.
The real test for Dr. Thomas and her team came in July 2006. 75 seconds into the flight and the missile suddenly went out of control. But Dr. Thomas decided to take it up as a challenge and prove her point.
And 10 months later, they did. The team relaunched the missile and it flew for around 16 minutes.
It was really a learning lesson, but it went off well. We all wanted to prove that it is all intact, he said.
The success came at a price. To be at the launch, Tessie left behind a sick son about to write his board exams. But he's aptly named after the country's light combat fighter jet, Tejas, and lived up to his name.
I feel, yeah, that she has managed it really well, because whenever the nation requires her, or the work, wherever she's working, whenever she has to be present there, she's always been there. Whenever I needed her, she was always with me.
Today, Dr. Thomas leads a team of 400 scientists, the majority of whom are male, but it doesn't faze her.
Subject is subject, science is science, and science doesn't have any gender.